bear with me if this video sounds a little bit too noisy to you, because this is the very problem I'm going to solve here. The other day I received a comment complaining that my video is a little bit too noisy. Absolutely incredible, which I think is true. So I spent some efforts and found a great solution using this type of shotgun mic. So it picks up the front voice, but cancels most of background noise, which is exactly what I wanted. So first of all, let's see how it works. Do you think it's better? The good news is that it does work, though it doesn't cancel 100% of noise, but it does improve the sound quality a lot. However, the bad news is that it is not as simple as just a matter of plugging. Those DSLR shotgun mic does require a bit of efforts to make them work on phones or iPhone in my case. So stay with me to see how I made them work. So I have my Android phone and the Sennheiser mic. The good thing about this kind of solution is that once you get your Sennheiser mic work on one device, like say Android device, it actually works across all different types of devices. Your iPhone, your Android phone, your laptop, DSLRs. So this is really great about this solution. Let me turn on my phone, start recording. You probably can see the response of the waveform here, which means my voice is being picked up by this phone right now. And since nothing's connected, apparently this phone is doing the job right now. So I plug this thing directly into this phone and my voice is still being recorded. But who is actually working right now? So this is the easy solution to find out. You know, the phone usually have a mic, you know, installed somewhere on the bottom. So I've tapped this area. Ooh, that's pretty strong, you know, pulses, which means probably this area is working or picking up my voice. To verify this, let's do this. Let's remove the windshield. Tap this. Nothing. Only my voice. Yep, that's telling you most likely, okay, the phone is working even though it's connected. So the Sennheiser mic does not work directly with the phone. Well, in order to further prove that I'm correct, I'm taking up my final solution. Yeah, I will show you guys how to do this later. But now, let's just use it. Okay, let's connect this and connect back to the phone. Let's do the experiment again. Okay. Nothing. And actually, it's not even picking up voice because the shotgun is facing against me, which is great. Now let's tap it. Ooh, you see that? This time, it means the shotgun is working. Now let me, you know, facing towards me. Hello, hi, see, my voice got picked up. If I make it face against me, the response is much smaller, which is exactly what this kind of shotgun mic is doing. All right, obviously, the simple answer is no. The mic does not work out of box on a phone. Trust me, I tried all different sorts of, you know, solutions online. People are talking about the wiring issue just because, you know, they take different, you know, rings, display there, adapters. Trust me, don't waste your time. None of them worked. Bad, right? As an electrical engineer, does not work is not something I can accept as an answer. So I went a little bit deep to find out why and solve the problem successfully. So here is a comparison. This plugs into the phone, to tablets, to your laptop, work fine. This one does not work, but only works on DSLRs. If we look at a connector or the plugs here, they are the same 3.5 millimeter. However, this has four rings, this has three rings, but this is not a problem. For most of these four ring devices, I figured there are TRRS, which is ear left, ear right, ground, and mic. And I also figured on the Sennheiser mic, it has TRS, which is voice plus, voice minus, both of which makes the differential signal for the DSLRs. You might wonder, hey, why not just buy this kind of mic that has shotgun effects? Let me tell you, there's nothing like this, because all the shotgun thing is really complex.
it's not just a matter of condenser. You know, this device is very simple because just one piece of condenser there, phone or tablet or laptop, have, you know, those driving circuitry to drive this mic. So everything is basically designed to work with this kind of passive condenser to record a voice. However, on the shotgun side, it's quite complex. First of all, you can see there's a battery there. So it's active. So they do all sorts of noise cancellation. And sometimes they have more than one condenser microphone inside so that they can detect, you know, depending on the signal strength, where the signal is coming from, so they can cancel the noise from sides. That's how it works, and that's how they're so expensive.
All right, here I have my things connected. See, the white is ground. The red is picking up the voice. There's also a negative voice, which is used on DSRs for noise cancellation purpose. Right now, my oscilloscope is looking at these two leads and showing the waveform here. As an experiment, let me just blow into it, see how it works. All right, see that? If I knock on thing, it's also causing some vibration, which means, you know, this device, as I just explained before, so it's an active device. It actively outputs signal when it is connected. So as a comparison, now I'm connecting the common earbuds with mic. If I blow into it right now, you don't see any output from the oscilloscope. Because as I explained before, this device needs external circuitry to work. So if nothing is connected, it's basically just a condenser. It's not gonna output any signal.
That's why, even if you rewired the rings here and make sure their positions are correct, the circuitry on a phone, on a tablet, will just not accept this. Because they're not expecting any active circuitry come in. They're only expecting some passive device like this. But anyway, so if you want a noise cancellation shotgun mic that only recording the voice from front, you have to choose this type of device. When you choose this type of device, it came with its own circuitry that does not work with most of the phones and tablets, laptop, which is dead. Now, the solution seems to be simple right now, is that if we can build something in between this and the phone so that mimic this active microphone as a passive microphone, so that first of all, the device will recognize it, and then somehow still passing its signal onto the device, then I think the problem can be solved.
So first of all, this is a pseudo circuitry that is usually implemented in your phone or tablet or computer. While the details might be very different, we just put it here as a concept. We don't have to know too much details about it. When a condenser mic got plugged in, as you can see here, a condenser has some internal impedance. As soon as it plugs in, the DC will flow from the power to ground so that this will notify the device, okay, there's a mic got plugged in. Then when the voice vibrates the membrane, the signal will pass through the capacitor into the circuitry for digital sampling. So this is how it worked. Now we need to remove the condenser. And instead, we're gonna connect the shotgun mic to that port. Again, we don't know the internal circuitry. All we know is the exposed pins. First, we need to mimic the output impedance from a condenser. So we need to put a resistor here just to let the DC flow so that the phone or the tablet will realize, oh, there's a mic got plugged in. Second, the signal from a shotgun mic is useful. However, it could be biased differently that the phone could not accept. That's why we need a capacitor here. Capacitor will be a short circuit for AC, but open circuit for DC. So we connect these together. Of course, don't forget about the ground. The output impedance of a condenser is usually from 500 to 1 kilo ohm. And the capacitor is usually from 1 to 2.2 microfarad. All right, so apparently the red part is the circuit we need to make so that these two things will work together eventually. And don't worry, this is a really simple circuit. I'm sure you can do that too. I made a more professional version of circuits, which is pretty fun. So if you want, you can actually make use of the other two pins that are for the earphones to extend the earphones as well. So you have a full functioning adapter for both input and output. All right, it's time for the real work. Okay, so I just finished soldering this adapter. You can see the right side will plug into the phone. If it's iPhone, you plug into the iPhone through a lightning adapter. The left side is for your Sennheiser mic or any Shure mic, and as well as a pair of earbuds. And I also made a simpler version in case you just need to record your voice, so this will work as well.